pray to the day I die. Lustilla, come villa, come hither. Beat the sharp side of my knife, become the blood dripper. Cock splinter, blunt ripper. Never front bitcher, unleash the fucking dripper. This dripper, hitch dipper. The devil motivate me, bitch. I see him every day up in the mirror.
Yeah, bro.
I got my first bike when I was 16 months old.
Been riding since I was 3 years old, raced since I was four.
I actually got a bike for my fifth birthday.
Been riding since I was about 4 or 5 years old.
Got my first bike on my fifth Christmas.
When I was like 3 years old, my dad put me on a PW50 and started me off young.
So ever since then, I've been riding dirt bikes.
My family has been into it for a long time, and my dad was quite a racer back when in his younger days, so I just was kind of naturally brought into it.
He had a PW50 just sitting in the garage, and he said if you can ride a two-wheeler bicycle, then you can ride that. So later that day, just hopped on the bicycle, rode around for a little while, pulled the training wheels off, and that was that. Started there, and next weekend went racing in Abbotsford Arena Cross.
And I remember riding around in my backyard, and I set up pieces of wood and plywood sheets with like 2x4s under it, made little jumps and stuff, crashing the fence a couple times. And I was super hyped, super stoked.
When I first started, it was just trail riding. Like, I'd just go out and follow my dad around until I was 12. From there, I just raced as much as I could and got bumped up to pro when I was 15. My parents fully supported me, and I just kind of did that for a few years anyways.
I started riding with my sister's friends. That was the first time I ever rode a dirt bike, and once I discovered it, it was just like a miracle. Like, it was just amazing. Like, I couldn't help ride my dirt bike every day.
Just when you're out on the bike, you don't really think about anything else in the world. You're totally focused on riding and hitting your lines and just enjoying the moment, and nothing else really matters when you're out on the bike.
When you're not riding, you don't have anything to look forward to. I like going to the track, and I like having the adrenaline rush and the intensity and also the nerves on the gate.
I like racing like a lot with how competitive it is and stuff. I'm a competitive dude, so it's cool, like, especially when it's like you got a good battle on your hands and stuff, and it's like I like pushing it to the edge and stuff, and fighting off guys and stuff like that. So I'd probably say I like the racing better.
Come on, get up here. Okay. For the most part, anytime I got on the track, it was fun. But I think after around 2008, 2009, I started to just kind of get burnt out on the whole racing scene. I wanted to go back to my roots and explore like the hills again, and like really get back to doing what I enjoyed to do on a bike. Quit racing cold turkey right there. I was just done. And then just started riding the hills and doing my thing. I just went back to being a free agent and doing my own thing completely. No, nothing. I just decided, I was like, this just isn't really what I want to chase. Like, I don't really want to do this that bad anymore. I guess you could say I never really dedicated myself to racing. It was always just part of my life as I was growing up riding. I would more so say that my style is more along free riding and freestyle. It's a lifestyle thing, but at the same time, it's just the riding that we do is more fun. It's more along the style, or along the lines of my style. never really been a fan of the competition thing. I want to do the filming. I want to ride with my homies and help them progress and just keep growing the sport and doing what I can for the sport. I would never trade anything for it. There's nothing that could make me as happy as riding a dirt bike. 100%. Bikes are just, it's just my life. I've been in it my whole entire life. I don't see myself going anywhere anytime soon.
Definitely a good and a bad side. You know, there's the glory and whatnot, but then nobody sees the sides where you work your ass off in the gym. And you can be from such a high to such a low in the matter of seconds. You know, you can work so hard all off season, you know, put in so much effort and a lot of money and whatnot, and then one little crash or slip up, and it could put you out for the whole season. And, you know, teams don't look at you, no one's gonna be paying you. You know, it's almost a reality check, like, should I do this or not? Like, should I go get a job and start making money? You know, I'm starting to get to the point where I gotta make money now. And, you know, you work so hard, and it's like if you have a normal job and you don't get paid. It's kind of tough at times.
I've seen so many people get hurt in the sport, and it's a part of the sport, and you need to accept that going into it, I think. But there's some injuries that are life-changing. Like, one of my best friends is paralyzed from the chest down. So I think we take those risks when we get on the dirt bike, and we know those things can happen, but I don't think anyone's ever planning on that to happen to them. But when it does happen, it makes you think, like, is it worth it? Like, would I rather stay at home and not rode that day that happened to me?
Yeah, when I was probably 16, had a bad crash when I was down in the States, and that put me out for 2 years. I tore my ACL, concussion, broken leg and dislocated collarbone all in one crash. Did surgery, and then first race back, I re-injured my knee, and that put me out for probably another 6 months, so.
You can't change it, obviously, but, and I mean, you could get hurt walking across the street, so you don't want to hold yourself back from something because you could get hurt, but I think we all need to know, I think we all do know that that is a big downfall with our sport, and we should take all the protective measures we can to not be hurt.
Being like popular at school with friends is kind of hard when you're gone at months at a time. And yeah, when your teachers just aren't able to work with you about what you actually want to do with your life. And it's just, they think you're just skipping school. It's kind of hard, and especially when you live in Canada and you don't have the opportunity to go ride as much as people in the States do. And when you do take the time off, people get mad and yeah, but I did try homeschooling for half a semester, and I just absolutely hated it because I didn't get to see any of my friends every day, and I just wanted to go back.
I still got a lot of love for the sport left in me, so I think that keeps me pushing forward and just wanting to, you know, train that much harder to be that much better. There's definitely times where at the end of a season, you know, you just need a couple week break to recover for, you know, the next series coming up, but I definitely feel that when you work hard, then success will come, and that's what pays off. That's the glory right there. So
if you want to do good in this sport, you got to be kind of all in, and you know, I've been working full-time, and that takes a lot of my time away, 5 days a week, 6 days a week sometimes, so not a whole lot of free time, and then it's hard because, when you know, obviously I want to be riding and getting better and practicing and training in the gym and stuff like that, but I know I got to make money, and you know, I'll come home from work and usually I'll just end up going to bed or something, eat food and go to bed, and it's hard to find time for the training and stuff like that. But I've given my 2 weeks notice to my guys, and I'm looking to try to go all in and make a go for it and try to do good this summer and just really put the effort in. So
I think that's happened within the last, I would say, 5 years, I would say, kind of, where, you know, like, your kid's got to have the best gear, your kid's got to have the best bike, and if they don't, then they can't compete at the top level, which is true to an extent, I guess you could say. But I mean, I feel like we get so wrapped up in it. Like, I know families that are spending every last penny they can on dirt bikes, and that is the most important thing. And really, if you look at it, it's not. You know, there's more to life than riding dirt bikes. So I see, like, a lot of kids, like, wanting to get to the top, you could say, and they've given up everything to ride dirt bikes, and the odd one or two are going to be able to do it till they're 25, you know, and the rest are going to have to get jobs when they're 20. And then we have, you know, these kids quit school in grade 8 and grade 9, and then they don't have their grade 12 education. So when they quit, when they're 20, they don't have school. The only skill they really have is riding dirt bikes. If that's your dream and you want to ride dirt bikes, like, I have more power to you, but I don't think you should forget about other things in life that are really important too. I guess I personally value education, and I value life skills, and I think that's something we should all have. So, like, I think if parents put a heavier importance on school instead of on racing, it might be a different outcome for a lot of kids. But at the same time, these kids are working really hard to follow their dream and race for a living. So it's kind of a catch-22. But I don't think I could live without my dirt bike. I think it's one of the greatest joys I have in life, so.
I think in the back of my head, it's just like, I kind of just want to pack up and go home and never see this thing again. But next day, I'm just looking at my dirt bike and like, hey, I got to take this thing out.
The longer you're off the bike, it just makes you want it more and want to try and get back on the bike and do better than you did before.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah. Worth every minute of it. Yeah. I've been doing it since I was 7 years old, so you know, it's basically my life.
Yeah, I don't know if I could really see myself enjoying some of the safer, more mellow sports. Just, I guess you could say I'm a bit of an adrenaline junkie, as they call it.
Yeah, my dad's been hyped on it ever since, so he loves it. I don't know what we'd be doing. I don't know what he'd be doing if we didn't do this. He'd probably be going crazy, so it's fun. We both really enjoy it, so it's good.
Oh yeah, riding for sure is an escape. I mean, it's like a weight off your shoulders. You get on your bike and there's nothing else. It's just you and the bike. I like the competitive side of it, but for me, if I get stuck in my head, I'm having a rough day or whatever, going out riding is just shutting my brain off, and it's just flowing with the bike and the track, and that's when I'm at one with myself. And it might look chaotic from the outside, but it's kind of like everything slows down. It's just, I don't know, you get laser focus and it's unexplainable. I mean, I don't even care what the lap times are, but just pushing myself that little bit more and coming into this corner a little harder and just making sure my form's right. I mean, that's one of my favorite things, is just motos and getting that cardio workout out of it. I don't know, the high after riding is unbeatable for sure. Yeah, for myself personally, I know I got a lot of energy and it's gonna come out whether it's positive or negative, and riding my dirt bike and out of the track, it's definitely a positive way to put my energy to use. Growing up racing motocross and training hard and working towards a goal, I think builds a lot of character in kids, and I think that I wouldn't be who I am today without racing. I think I would be, I have no idea where I'd be. I don't know. It's hard to imagine life without riding or racing.
Hey, Wyatt.
You know, I'm gonna fucking lay the boots to her. Simple as that.
Liking riding dirt bike. Oh fuck, okay, restart.